Well, I grew up in these islands of Galapagos. That's an amazing place, an island far away from the coast of the mainland South America. It's 600 miles. These are volcanic islands, and I just was born there. I was just lucky that my family went there, and they were pioneers in this island. So it was an amazing childhood. These islands are just surrounded by ocean, and the waters are crystal clear. So swimming, snorkeling, that was the games that we had as kids, just going in the water, play with the water, and just seeing these animals with big iguanas, these tortoises. And that's really an amazing experience, just to be looking at the birds, these frigate birds, just with the pouches inflated, all these animals. At one point, we're just lying down, looking to the sky, all these animals flying above me. That was really my best experience in my life. Well, landscapes in these islands are just so amazing because the geological part is the most interesting part of these islands, because these islands are young. It's only 3 to 5 million years ago when the volcanoes were erupting under the sea, and then eventually it formed islands in the middle of the ocean. So these islands are young. Oh yes, there is one island in the bay. It's called Bartolome Island, and it has a rock with the name Pinnacle Rock, and we climb to the top, we climb to the volcano of the island. There are some lavas which are only 100 years old, and you can just see, you can just imagine how was the beginning of these islands.
It's impossible to describe a typical area of Ecuador. Ecuador has the Galapagos Islands, we have a cloud forest, we have the Andes, and of course the Amazon tropical rainforest. So each area of Ecuador is unique and incredibly diverse. The people of Ecuador are a product of the nation, so we are incredibly diverse.
What an incredible house! And this is the typical architecture from the 15th, 16th century. You can still see part of the wood and some of the paintings up in the ceiling.
This is a wood carving. Looks like it's one single piece of wood made into the face of an old bean. That's a wonderful work.
Buenos días. ¿Se puede?
Buenos días.
¿Qué tal? ¿Cómo estás? Man, this is amazing. ¿Cómo estás?
Bien. ¿Qué tal? ¿Cómo te va?
Chévere. Qué super chévere tu tarea. This is
gracias.
A very amazing workshop, man.
Gracias, gracias.
¿Qué trabajas? ¿En joyas?
Sí, trabajo en oro, en plata, hago engastes con gemas preciosas.
Oh, qué bacán. Mm. Super chévere. ¿Cómo te llamas?
Edwin.
Edwin. Bueno. So you work in silver, in gold. Ah, this is really great. Mm.
Alrededor de 2 días me demoraré, sí.
So 2 days just to make this one here, oh man. This is great. So this is silver, es plata.
Sí. And, este es una piedra que se llama ojo de tigre.
All right, so stone. ¿Y estos materiales lo consigues de aquí?
Sí, tenemos la suerte de aquí en el Ecuador tener la plata, el oro, entonces es más fácil para trabajar.
So
la materia prima.
Made in Ecuador, that's great.
Trabajando, bueno, estudié en el extranjero también.
Yeah.
Y los años con la experiencia, la práctica.
Maybe I can make something for my wife. Wow. That has to stay like that, very strong. So with that little trap, you can make a ring. 500 centigrade, so you can melt the silver. Ahí está casi líquido. Yep. Almost like it's floating around.
Ahora lo que vamos a hacer ya es enfriar un poco esto y vamos a laminar para empezar a construir ya el anillo.
So as soon as you take the flame off, mm-hmm. it gets back to be solid. So I have to put it here, right? And then just turn it off. And have to get it on the other side, yeah? And then I move to the next one. So it's going flat and flat and flat. Every time that I pass it through, it keeps getting flatter. And now it's coming up. ¿Qué tal ahí?
Perfecto.
¿Hay que pasarlo otra vez?
Un poco más. So, bajamos las masas con el volante.
Ah, so with this you tied it up, all right. There it goes. Y ahí va. Ah, man. Didn't have any idea that today it was the day for me to learn how to make a ring. ¿Qué tal ahí? It looks good, man. And thanks to the master, because otherwise I was not able to do it. So muchas gracias al maestro.
Yeah, de nada.
Le deja adobada la piel.
Ya le deja adobada la piel. El fuego, mire cómo está el fuego.
So that's what it gives the flavor to the dish, uh-huh. The special flavor is the charcoal. And she's not using any propane gas. So she said that this is what it gives to her preparation, a whole different flavor.
El famoso.
El famoso agrio.
Ah, so that is the one that is the famous
Este es el famoso agrio. Porque es hecho a base de chicha, tomate, perejil, cebolla blanca, azúcar y un poco sal. Por eso es agridulce.
So it's a bitter sour taste.
Uh-uh.
75 years ago, and I've been doing like this. Muchas gracias. Se ve delicioso. It looks really yummy. Now, this is something that you don't see in the other part of the colonial center.
These are the families that live still in this building. And this is what makes this part different. Because here the building still belongs to the family.
Most of the other part of the colonial center, the lower floor of the building has been rented or is already sold. And the families, they don't live there anymore.
So this neighborhood, San Marcos, is still a residential neighborhood.
Yeah, as you can see on the sign, this is the famous San Marcos neighborhood.
Now right in this place, you can see the change of architecture. So what we have seen so far is buildings from the 16th century. And here we move on to a new era of the city of Quito. So most of these buildings right here, they are from the 50s. So you can see the change on both from balconies straight down to more like, let's say, typical kind of buildings.
Growing up in Galapagos was so different because it is something nice growing up with animals. But something I can say, growing up with conservation is very nice. Galapagos is one of the places that we don't talk about conservation. We live and act every day about that. To be in Galapagos is already something unique, not in Ecuador and in this beautiful planet. There can be a beach where you're just sitting there with a beautiful color of the water, where it's no garbage in the area, no plastic bottles, nothing like that. then you are watching this beautiful landscape in a beautiful beach, nice weather, and then you have a sea lion passing by you or coming, smelling your leg, or a bird coming on your head or around, no, and you're just quiet there, you just don't move because you are part of that, no? That is some unique places and it's almost all around. Any place you decide to sit, you can fly away of everything and to be with the nature around.